Okay, this is a very interesting case. Case 4. Now this case 4, I would prefer to write it somewhere over here. Okay, case 4. Case 4 when the function looks something like e raised to ax into v. E raised to ax into v. And yp for this will be 1 upon f of b operating on e raised to ax into v. Now there is a very interesting way how to solve this. This e raised to ax has the ability to come outside e raised to ax, and the d gets replaced by d plus a, and that you operate on v. So in short, whenever you have a function which is of the type e raised to ax into v, this e raised to ax can come outside your 1 upon f of d, but as it comes outside, d gets replaced by d plus a. Basically the a comes from here. Okay? Just a couple of sums down the line and you will be able to figure this out very easily. So, from our notes, I am taking case 4 and the very first example, okay, of case 4 that I am taking is d square minus 4d operating on y. Sorry, it is minus 4d minus 5 operating on y is equal to x into e raised to minus x. X into e raised to minus x. Now, again, I have complete faith in all of you that you will be able to do the YC part on your own. So let me just go ahead and concentrate on the most important part of the solution, that is YP. So this becomes your f of d, this becomes your capital X. So if I have to find out the YP for this, YP will be 1 upon d square minus 4d minus 5 operating on x into e raised to minus x. Okay? I will rewrite this as 1 upon say d minus 5 into d plus 1. Isko maine factorize kiya. And that I am operating on e raised to minus x into x. Now if you watch carefully, aapko ye e raised to ax ki tarah dikhega aur ye samjho ki ye hai aapka v. So it is like e raised to ax into v. Now e raised to ax into v jab hota hai, then this e raised to ax can come outside. So you will have over here this e raised to ax term coming outside. So e raised to minus x. And what happens is, whenever this term comes out, the d gets replaced by d plus a. A over here is minus 1. Ax is minus 1x. So a is equal to minus 1. So d has to be replaced by d plus a, that is d minus 1. So what happens is here, d will be replaced by d minus 1. Minus 5. D minus 1 plus 1, and now what remains over here is simply x. So this e raised to minus x comes out, you have simply x remaining over there. So you will have e raised to minus x. Ye minus 1 plus 1 cancel ho jayega, so 1 upon d bachega. Uske alawa 1 upon d minus 6 operating on x. Now this x is nothing but x raised to 1. And x raised to 1 should remind you of x raised to m. That means we are again back to case 3. So itna aap yaad rakhiye ke aapko pancho cases achhi tarah se malum hone chahiye for you to do this entire thing properly. So now when this e raised to minus x is kept as it is, 1 upon d is also kept as it is. Now when you concentrate on 1 upon d minus 6 operating on x, केस 3 में डिस्कस किया था कि ये जो आपका f of d है ना, f of d, this f of d has to be expressed as 1 plus or minus something, और वो 1 लाने के लिए आपको lowest degree term common लेना पड़ेगा among 3 and minus 6, which is the lowest degree term over here, obviously minus 6, so I'll take minus 6 common. माइनस सिक्स को आप अगर कॉमन लेते हो तो माइनस सिक्स की जगह पर बचता है वन और ये डी की जगह पर बचेगा माइनस डी बाय सिक्स. दैट यू हैव टू ऑपरेट ऑन एक्स. सो प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड, माइनस सिक्स इंटू वन इज माइनस सिक्स, माइनस सिक्स इंटू माइनस डी बाय सिक्स इज यू डी. ओके, लेट अस गो अहेड. सो दिस विल नाउ बिकम ई रेज टू माइनस एक्स वन अपॉन डी into minus 1 upon 6 also, and 1 upon 1 minus something, okay, 1 upon 1 minus something can be written as 1 upon 1 minus x, and this can be expanded like this, so it will be 1 plus d by 6 plus dot 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 apply on it. यहाँ पे आप लोगों ने देखा कि मेरे डॉट्स बहुत जल्दी चालू हो गए यहाँ पे. Why? Because x का पावर इज 1, so I have to expand also to the power of 1 only as far as d is concerned. So therefore, you will get your minus e raised to minus x upon 6, 1 upon d, 1 operating on x will give you x. 1 upon 6 and derivative of x will give you 1. Still the answer cannot be said to be complete because 1 upon d is still remaining over here, and this will be minus e raised to minus x upon 6, 1 upon d operating on x will give you x square by 2, and 1 upon d operating on 1 upon will give you x by 6. Please remember, 1 upon d is nothing but integration. So this becomes your y. This becomes your y. I sort of forgot to tell you कि जो अभी हम लोग जो solve कर रहे हैं वो unsolved examples है class 4 के. There are probably one or two solved examples in each case also. Please see to it that you go through the solved examples scrutinizingly. Don't ignore the solved examples. They are also very important and they will also teach you many many concepts. Okay? I'll just take up the fourth sum, okay, which is d cube plus d square minus d minus 1 y operating on cos square x into e raised to x. Okay, cos square x e raised to x. Now over here, this is basically your f of d and this is your capital X. Once again, I am not so much emphasizing on how to find yc, that I am sure you will be able to do it. Let us take the yp part of it seriously. So yp is equal to 1 upon, this is your f of d, that is d cube plus d square minus d minus 1. Operating on e raised to x into cos square x. E raised to x into cos square x. So, surprisingly, this is of the type e raised to ax, where a is 1 and this is your v. So, this capital X is of the type e raised to ax into v. Okay? Now, this type mein e raised to ax can come out, but the d will be replaced by d plus a. Okay? So, over here, okay, let us try to be a little conservative. I can rewrite this as 1 upon, in dono mein se main d square common leta hu. So, in the bracket, I will get d plus 1. In dono mein se main minus common leta hu. Bracket mein I will get d plus 1. And this will be operating on e raised to x into cos square. Abhi, d plus 1 common le rahe the, I will get d plus 1 over here and I will get d square minus 1 operating on e raised to x into cos square x. Isko main finally likh sakta hu 1 upon, see d square minus 1 is also d plus 1 into d minus 1. D plus 1 already hai yahan pe, so it will become d plus 1 the whole square into d minus 1 operating on e raised to x into cos square x. Okay? Now, let me invite this e raised to x out. So, I will get e raised to x out. Lekin, ye jaise hi bahar aata hai, the d gets replaced by d plus a. A over here is 1. So, d will get replaced by d plus 1. So, this will be d plus 1. Plus 1 the whole square, d plus 1 is already done. So d plus 1 plus 1. And this will become d plus 1 minus 1. So it will simply become d. Okay? And that you need to operate on cos square. That you need to operate on cos square. Now, this will become your e raised to x. 1 upon d ko I will write it as it is only. इसके अलावा बचा 1 upon d plus 2 the whole square which is d square plus 4d plus 4 operating on cos square x है. Cos square x I will write as 1 plus cos 2x upon 2. 1 plus cos 2x upon 2. Okay? This 2, I will invite it outside. So, you will get e raised to x upon 2. 1 upon d. Abhi, ye 2 to bahar aa gaya. Okay, 1 upon d pehle se bahar hai. 1 upon this operates on 1. And 1 upon this entire thing operates on cos 2x. Okay, let us view both of them separately. 1 upon f of d operating on 1 means 1 upon f of d operating on e raised to 0x. E raised to 0x like e raised to ax. So we replace d by a. So when we replace d by a, you will get 1 upon 0 plus 0 plus 4 operating on e raised to 0x. So ye 1 ka bandobast ho gaya. So you will get e raised to x upon 2, 1 upon d. The overall simplification of this term is simply 1 upon 4, that's all. Then we come to 1 upon this entire thing applied on cos 2x. Applied on cos 2x means applied on cos ax, where d square has to be replaced by minus a square. D square has to be replaced by minus a square. A is 2. A square will be 4. Minus a square will be minus 4. So the d square I will replace by minus 4. Plus 4d plus 4. This has to be operated on cos 2x. And luckily for us,
this minus 4 and plus 4 gets cancelled. When something like this doesn't get cancelled, what to do? That will be dealt in the solved examples. So please, that's why I told you, go through the solved examples very, very nicely. So now, what you are left out over here is 1 upon 4. Okay, 1 upon 4 then bacha. Uske alawa bacha 1 upon d cos 2n. Okay, what is the meaning of 1 upon d? 1 upon d is nothing but integration of cos 2x. Integration of cos 2x is sin 2x upon 2. So, ye ban jayega sin 2x upon 8. Because 4 pehle se hi hai yahan pe. Now, answer is still not complete because 1 upon d is still there in the answer. So, therefore, this gets simplified to e raised to x upon 2. 1 upon d, but the integration of 1 upon 4 is x upon 4. And integration of sin 2x, integration of sin 2x will be minus cos 2x upon 2, but upon 8 pehle se hi hai, so ye upon 16 ho jayega. So this will be the YP part of the solution. The whole solution over here can be written as Y is equal to YC plus YP. So please, the solution is still here. So I think for case 4, okay, these two examples are sufficient, okay, and through the solved example you will get to know much more better scenario as far as some complications are concerned. So this was all about case 4, okay. We will also take up case 5 in some time, okay?